Welcome to the dogs.com.au wrap up on today, Monday, January 20. What another huge week it's been in greyhound racing, so let's get straight into it. Today, we'll begin with a look at all of the Group 1 action from Wentworth Park, where Feral Frankie brought the house down. Get trainer reaction from all of the Group 1 features. Take a look at the end of a record run. Tony Mestrov's visit to the bushfire affected New South Wales South Coast, while Tab Racing returns to the Mid-North Coast. Before covering off on all you need to know for the upcoming Illawarra Pet Festival. But first, let's head straight to Wentworth Park now, where one of the biggest 48 hours on the Greyhound Racing New South Wales calendar took place over the weekend, with the running of the Group 1 National Futurity and National Derby heats on Friday night, and the Group 1 Ladbrokes Paws of Thunder heats contested on the Saturday. On the opening night, where the rain made itself known, it would be Jason McKay who would dominate proceedings, claiming two heats of the Derby, along with two heats of the Futurity to make it a night to remember for the Hunter Valley trainer. Hardstyle Rico would be the star performer for McKay, with his gun sprinter reigning in one of the biggest names in greyhound racing right now, Simon told Helen, to record a stunning Heat 2 victory in the Derby.
Hardstyle Rico going to a clear second. They've dropped Hooray Zipper. They were followed up by Richard Donald Weblack Hayes. Then Federal Estate on Route 66 at the tail. Simon told Helen led. We've got a race. Hardstyle Rico, Mick moved up on the outside. He sailed on by. Oh, Hardstyle Rico, that is outstanding.
He's a special young dog for sure, Liam, this dog to give the lead of the black a start like that and beat him a length and three quarters is you got to sort of look to make sure it really happened, mate. That's probably the best young dog around, the leader, and somehow he's given two or three lengths start and beat him two lengths. That's a proper young dog in.
Here's how the field will look for Friday night's Group 1 Ladbrokes National Derby, with the Heat 3 winner Rampant Jimmy drawing the checks. Leading Victorian Simon told Helen the 4 inside Hardstyle Rico in the yellow, with Aston Sapporo in the 7. Now in the Futurity, it was McKay zipping Veyron who would post the fastest heat time on a rain-affected Wentworth Park track, going round in a time of 29.86.
Racing, zipping Veyron got away beautifully. The favourite's going to lead on a rear by three through the first corner, rushing to second, Chunli out wide. The inside, Karinga Lily, the Karinga Lucy. They were followed up by Look Fancy Nancy, striking success. Lambmore Cutie, Talk About Katie is second last, and near the rear, Kenya Lily coming to the home corner. Zipping Veyron, a long leader over Karinga Lucy. Zipping Veyron getting tired, but in no danger. Veyron wins.
Yeah, good. She's, like we say, she's got those breakneck sections. She's probably, she don't want inside. She wants to draw middle to wide. She likes to funnel dogs, not get funneled herself, but nice, honest little bits. She's improving all the time. She's took a bit of a liking to this joint, so she went nice, yeah.
McKay's Aston Maeve has drawn box one in Friday night's Futurity final inside Heat 4 winner Run Bubba Run in the 2. Zipping Veyron will wear the blue with Wild Flyer in the yellow and Aston Silk out of the Thompson Kennels in the 7. On to Saturday night now, where we saw some of the biggest names in greyhound racing land at Wentworth Park for yet another night of Group 1 action. Four heats of the Group 1 Ladbrokes Paws of Thunder were contested, and who else would it be to steal the show but Feral Frankie, the People's Champion, with the Jack Smith star putting in a trademark display that raised the roof at Wentworth Park.
Feral Frankie's on the move, then wanted to duck wide. They'll follow by Adanga, Jack Goodon's buddy, Leon Bale, Shanjo Prince at the tail, Kai Shen the leader by three. Feral Frankie's are coming hard there, followed by Who Told Stevie, Kai Shen in front. Here he comes, the Feral drives, got there. Feral Frankie arrived in time.
Yeah, he makes me smile. He just doesn't matter. He's just exciting to watch, whether he wins or loses. But yeah, I definitely smile more when he wins. Yeah, well, I didn't know whether he'd won or not, but when I heard the crowd roar, I assumed he did. Yes, it is. We appreciate everything that's going on around him, and we're just happy to be training. I said it before, we're just so lucky to have him in the kennel.
As we can see from Jack there, he certainly is one greyhound who makes a smile. Prior to the People's Champion setting the track alight, it was two Victorians under Jeff Britton's watchful eye that would set the benchmark for the Paws of Thunder heats, with 2019 Melbourne Cup runner-up Western Envoy claiming Heat 1 and Oakvale Beauty claiming Heat 2 in a best of night 29.64.
She's charging over Oakvale Beauty and Randa the lead. Nangar Diva is going to hold second position. They'll follow it up by Starter Right, Jaro Bale, and then seal the deal, Jill Caroma. Kid Candle Vouchers at the tail. Oakvale Beauty by two, Nangar Diva, then Starter Right. Oakvale Beauty in the lead and going great guns. Oakvale Beauty, too good.
Yeah, absolutely. It's obviously, we've brought four dogs up here for tonight and all four have qualified. So, yeah, I'm sure the team at home is really happy and go on to next week now.
The final of the 2020 Ladbrokes Paws of Thunder will look as follows. With the Feral drawing the red, Western Envoy the three, reigning champion Bucks Future the yellow, inside Oakvale Beauty, Orcation and King Kratos will round out this red-hot Group 1 field. We wish all greyhounds a safe journey and all the very best to trainers and connections. Another of the feature races run on Saturday night was the Ladbrokes Summer Distance Plate over the 720 metres, where we saw some of the best staying talent in the land on display. Robert Britton's Blazing Cartier took out Heat 1 in a time of 42.25. However, it would be Blue Moon Rising, trained by John Finn, who would record the fastest heat run, crossing the posts in a time of 42.19.
Blue Moon Rising by two. True Detective tries hard. Blue Moon Rising the leader. True Detective can't get him. Blue Moon Rising does it again.
The final of this year's Summer Distance Plate will no doubt be one to remember, with talent on display from boxes 1 to 8. Blazing Cartier will start from the Cherry, with Just Terms drawing the checks, and Blue Summer Sky the white. Another of Jeffrey Britton's champions, True Detective, will wear the 5, while Blue Moon Rising and China O'Brien will be looking to get across from boxes 7 and 8 respectively. This day's race already has the hallmarks of a classic, so be sure to tune in this Friday night. For all the information you need ahead of this Group 1 Festival of Greyhound Racing action, be sure to head to thedogs.com.au today. Now, we have some news released earlier today, with Greyhound Racing New South Wales announcing that TAB Racing will return to the mid-north coast of New South Wales in the near future, after the GRNSW board gave its approval for Taree to host TAB race meetings. While approval has been given, there will still be a number of upgrades needed to the venue to bring it up to TAB standard, which Greyhound Racing New South Wales is already in the process of undertaking. A key feature in the GRNSW strategic plan released in 2018 was for all participants to have access to TAB racing, and today's announcement is another step toward providing those on the mid-north coast with this racing option. Now, last week, we brought you news that Turbo Thomas, trained by Jason McKay, had broken the record for the most consecutive wins on Australian TAB tracks with 17 victories. Well, McKay was looking to extend that streak when he brought the record holder to Wentworth Park last Wednesday night. However, the dream run would not continue as he went down in the free-for-all to Hardaway Harada.
Turbo Thomas back the third. They'll follow then back the fourth is Tyson Tango. A long break in the field. Then the Riccobono and Chew the Fat. The leader down the back is Hardaway Harada. About to be joined by Bad Ronnie. Turbo Thomas two away is Bad Ronnie. Trying to get past Hardaway Harada. And next Tyson Tango as they turn. Hardaway Harada, Bad Ronnie. Bad Ronnie the outside. Hardaway Harada kicks back. And what a Hardaway Harada.
Once again, we'd like to congratulate Jason and Connections on this fantastic achievement. Now, onto some more sombre news, where last week, Greyhound Racing New South Wales CEO Tony Mestrov visited the New South Wales South Coast to witness the devastation the recent bushfires had left on the area. In particular, he took the time to meet with participants in the area and speak with them firsthand on the horror in which they faced when the fires came close to their properties.
It was, they all pulled together. There were 60 participants at the club as well as 120 dogs. I'm so proud of the Greyhound community. They really did bandy together. The club particularly kept us informed. And we're all about community. I think they showed in the fire period over the last couple of weeks.
Already, the Greyhound Racing New South Wales Red and Yellow Dog Appeal has raised over $11,500 throughout the month of January. And with over 10 days remaining this month, we are hoping for plenty more winners from boxes 1 and 5 for those in need. Finally, this weekend at the Bulli Showground, the Bulli Greyhound Racing Club will be hosting the Illawarra Pet Festival in conjunction with the New South Wales Greyhounds as Pets program. Held across Saturday and Sunday, the festival will celebrate all the things we love about our pets and will be jam-packed with action for the whole family. With a free jumping castle, pet fashion parade, market stalls, pet market, and plenty more, you will not want to miss out on this day to remember. Make sure you head to illawarrapetfest.com to find out all of the details you need for you and your furry friend. Well, that's all we have time for today. We hope you've enjoyed this episode of the dogs.com.au wrap-up. But until next week, bye for now.